Family, welcome back to the channel, you guys. If you're new here, you are highly welcome. My name is Joyce, and if you've not subscribed to join the Unique family, like, what are you waiting for? Like, what are you still waiting for? Please go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Join the Unique family, because over here we are lit and we drop lit content all the time, okay? All right, you guys, I just want to simply say a very big thank you to all the Unique family and those who are here to join the Unique family, to everyone who has been sharing our videos. Oh my goodness, the love has been massive. Like, the love we've been getting has been massive. So we do not take it for granted. That is why I'm here to appreciate you all. May God guide and protect each and every one of you. Thank you so much. The lovely comments, the love, the likes. Oh my God. Thank you, thank you, thank you. May God bless and protect you all for me. And we don't take it for granted. Thank you. So today's video, there's a comment that has been coming in. I said, okay, let me just quickly see that and address it. This comment that keeps coming about, oh, before you guys decided to go back to your country, you must have made a lot of money and you must have built your houses and you have already planned the comfortable life you want to live before you decide to move back to your country. So I want to address this. In some cases, it's not always like that. When someone decides to move back to their country, that might be one reason. Yes, I have made it. I'm comfortable and I want to move back to my country. That might be one reason, but not in all cases. When you see someone move back to their country, one reason might be because they need freedom. Their document has expired and they do not want to be caught by immigration and they decide to go back to their country to have a freedom by themselves. Second reason might be because they could not find the greener pasture in abroad and they decided to move back to their country. Third reason might be because of racism. Like, you guys know that, especially in Asia, there is so much racism over here in Asia. So it might be because of racism. It might be any reason. It can be any reason. So I don't know this narrative, like, we all have this mentality that some of us Nigerians have, that when someone said that they're moving back to Nigeria, and this narrative of, oh, you have made it, that's why you're back. Because of this narrative and this mindset of we Nigerians, because of the mindset we have with people in abroad, it has taken so much lives and it has caused so much harm than good, if I should say so. Because there are some people in abroad and they've actually seen it that abroad is not favoring them. They are not making it over there. But because of they don't want to come back, they don't want their family and friends to laugh at them, saying that they come back empty-handed. That is why they will keep staying and they will keep struggling and they will keep suffering in abroad, begging for money to eat because they do not want to go back. Meanwhile, if they go back to their country, they might have a better life than the one they have while in abroad. Like, I could remember 2015 when I came to Malaysia, I was still staying with my brother and the wife at Jeras. That time I was new. I didn't know about this immigration of it, busing condos and carrying people with no documents. And there is this man that lives in that condo. That man, like, I used to greet him. Like, he's very, very friendly and he's such a good man. He's very tall, buoyant, full of life and very healthy man that just lost his life because he was running away from immigration so that they would not send him back to Nigeria. He jumped from floor 7 to lobby and he died and could not make it when they took him to the hospital. He died. He died leaving his 3 kids and a wife in Nigeria because he does not want to go back empty-handed. Because he does not want to go back so that people will not laugh at him that, oh, you spent how many years in abroad and you came back with nothing. He died because he just was looking for a better life for him, for the kids and the wife. But his document has expired. What about he should have just gone back to Nigeria with his life and then maybe look for another country to go to. But instead of that, he did not leave the country when his document has expired. He stayed back. He stayed back because he does not want shame. He does not want people to laugh at him. He does not want family and friends to laugh at him. So now they have to now send him back to Nigeria with his dead body. Which one would have been better? The one would have been better is it not him going home, you know, even though he goes back. Like, do not care what anybody say. If you know you don't have the document in abroad when you are in abroad, or the abroad is not favoring you, you have no big mansions, you have not buy that car they are expecting of you, do not fucking care what anybody has to say. You just go home and have your freedom, have your peace of mind, and just have your freedom. I'm telling you, instead of, you know, running helter skelter all the time, people should just stop having that mindset. Stop having the mindset that anybody that goes home has made it and has a lot of money, and you guys, you know, we start asking the person for money. There are so many reasons behind some people going back to their country, moving back to their country. So I think we should stop having this mindset. It's really going to help, like, some of us in abroad. It's really going to help some of us because, you know, like, I remember when my school friend wanted to go back. She wanted to go back 2017. What she was more concerned about is, oh, they do not have money. They have no big house. What would they do if they go back? Their documents has expired and they are overstayed for like 3 months plus, and they keep staying, but they wanted to go. They actually wanted to go, but her only concern was, oh, people are going to laugh at her. People are going to laugh at her, especially her family, saying that she came back with nothing, especially when they asked her for money and she could not give the money to them, that they are going to laugh at her, saying that she went to abroad and came back with nothing and all that, and there will be gossip here and there. I told her, girl, do not listen to what anybody has to say. Finally, they went back, and I could remember she calling me and gisting me and letting me know that they did not let their family and friends know that they are back. They just stayed somewhere in Owerri and they did not let anybody know that they are back, but they've been in Nigeria because they did not want the heat. That's why they did not let their family know that they are back yet until they are ready. I was like, oh my goodness. This thing that we Nigerians are doing to anybody that comes from abroad is actually, like, it's actually not nice at all. It's actually not nice. So if you have a family and friends in abroad, sometimes do reach out to them, call them and care for them, show them the love, because they also do deserve it. It is not easy anywhere. Like, I've been seeing some of you comments saying, oh, you moved back to Nigeria, Nigeria is hard, it's not easy in Nigeria. My dear, it's not easy anywhere in the world. Like, it is not easy anywhere in the world. Abroad is hard. Nigeria is hard. Everywhere is hard. Before you make money in abroad, you have to work your ass up. Like, work your ass out. It's not easy at all. So, it's not easy in Nigeria and it's not easy in abroad. So, when we see someone who actually said they are moving back or who moved back to Nigeria, just let us show them the love they deserve, the love and support they deserve, because there might be so many reasons behind them moving back. Not just because they have made it, you understand? Not just because they have made it, they've made so much money and they've big mansion, they've owned cars, luxury cars and all the luxury things. No. There might be so many reasons behind their traveling back. So just let us be supportive and let's not have this mindset. Let's not have this mindset that we are having. Like, it's not good. And I will see you guys in my next video. I hope this video actually makes sense and I hope it's going to help some of us, because it will actually help a lot of people who are, especially families who are expecting so much from their people when they see them and when they are in abroad. It will help them to actually stop expecting so much. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed watching this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Stay tuned for my tomorrow's video, because I'm going to be doing a tour, our house tour. Yeah, stay tuned. I know you don't want to miss, and I'll see you guys later. Bye. My love, job, you give me love I never see. Oh, my love, job, your love means so much to me.